So during entire training or during entire lecture, keep your microphone on mute condition, unless and until it is required to unmute. Got it? Sometimes we will give to doubt clarification at the end of every session. So please don't ask any question during the ongoing session. If you have any query or doubts during ongoing session, just write in chat box only. If I feel it is necessary to answer that question, I will definitely give the answer during the lecture. But if I feel it is not important to answer this time, I will reply to that question at the end of the session and avoid to ask any question which is not related to ongoing topic. See, sometimes what happen, the ongoing topic is modeling, commands of the modeling, and like other discussion is going on, and in that discussion someone is asking about some other topic. Okay, so just don't do these things because create the disturbance. So I hope you all understood this. Okay, first of all we will see some introduction about the ETAP software, what actually in ETAP software, how it is come in market, and what the full form of the ETAPs. So ETAPs full form, the full form of the ETAPs is extended three-dimensional analysis of building system, and it is founded by the company whose name is Computer Structure Incorporation. This software was just a program and was developed by a group of students who pursued their masters in 1975. Later on, it is released officially as an integrated analysis design software in 1985. So basically it is a company under which there are many products in the form of the softwares in different fields. But if we are specifically talking about the structural design or structural point of view, so some of the products are ETAPS, SAFE, CSI Bridge, Perform 3D, CSI Column. These all are the products of the CSI company. Most of the iconic building of the world were analyzed and designed by these softwares. Because if you are going to deal with the high-rise structure, some commands, some features, and some advanced commands given in this software make it more effective for the users to build high-rise structure. So it is a well-known software in market for the designing purpose of RCC structure, which is especially high-rise structure. Okay, so this is a brief some introduction about the ETAP software. Then now we'll see the user interface of the ETAPs. When you go to open the ETAP software, see, if you are going to open the ETAP software without internet connection, the user interface will be like this. See, if you are going to open the ETAP software without internet connection, the welcome screen will be like this. There will be no anything, there will be blank page on the screen. What are these things we will discuss in detail later. So note that if you are opening the software without internet connection, the welcome screen will be like this. And if you are going to open this software with internet connection, see, the welcome screen will be like this. So what are the things given in this welcome screen, you will see one by one. See, there will be the new model option. What does mean by new model? Suppose you have to start the new product, new structure, modeling, defining, designing, analyzing, to do everything, you are going to start the new project. At that time you have to go through this option, new model. Then second option you can find here, open existing model. Suppose you have worked earlier on a particular project and that is saved in your system and you want to open that file, you just go through this option, open existing model. It will ask you the position or location of that file. Once you choose that file, that model will be open up. Below this, the recent model window is here. The recent works that you have done earlier, that is present here. So you just click on it, that model will be activated and you can start your work. So the recent model option is here. There will be latest news. If you opening this software with the internet connection, so this feature will be on your screen. So latest news, what's going on in the company, what's the new revisions or new versions available in different software categories, that all will be available here. Got it? And there will be the resources. See, resources. The ETAPS has given some videos, introductory videos. You can watch these videos and learn something from introductory videos given by the ETAPS software. Then some manuals is also uploaded by the company in the form of PDF. You can download this PDF and you can read it out and understand about the software. And also give the website option. Once you click on this website option, it will take you to the website. Got it? So this feature you can find only when you are starting the software with the internet connection only. If you are starting the software without being internet connection, you can find this type of user welcome screen. Got it? Okay. So in ETAPS, new model and open existing model option, you can also find from this bar, that is file. If you click on file, there will be a new model option. Once you click on new model, the new modeling or new work will be started. Once you click on open, it will ask the location of the file. Okay, once you select that file, the model will be open up. Just cancel it. Okay, so this top ribbon, it is actually called as top main menu bar. This is called as what? Top main menu bar. As you can find, many shortcut options are available here. This is called as quick access bar. This is called as quick access bar and this is called as top menu main menu bar. So I hope you are understood all this welcome screen. Now just go to file and open new model option. Just click on new model. Once you click on new model, a new dialog box will be open up under the name of model initialization. You can find three options here. First option is use saved user default setting. The second option is use settings from a model file. And third option is use built-in setting with. So one by one, we will try to understand what does mean by all these three options. Use saved user default setting. Under the first setting, suppose we have to start the new while modeling the structure, we need to define many of the things, like we have to define material properties, we have to define section properties, we have to define what are the methods of analysis we are going to perform, we need to define the load combinations. If you are going to deal with the high-rise structure, so we need to define about 70 to 75 load combination. So defining of all these things takes hell lot of times. It takes around 1 to 2 hours every time. So it's actually the time consuming work. And so to overcome these problem or to reduce the time of work, it has given this option. For a particular model, that entire default properties that we have defined, we can save in a default setting, in a ETAB default setting. Okay, there is an option when we go in ETAB software, I will show you how to save the settings for a particular model as a default setting. So when we select this option, all the properties, all the load combination, all the sections, all the material properties, all the method of analysis will be recalled by the ETAB software and it is saved in the settings. We don't need to define again and again. Got it? So this is all about the first option, use saved user default settings. Now the second option is use settings from a model file. Okay, use settings from a model file. Suppose you have to select, take a properties from a particular model. So at that time, you have to select, go through this option. Once you click on it and say okay, it will ask you about the position of the model that you want to select, that you want to choose the properties, defined properties from that model. So you have to select select that model and say open. So all the properties will be recovered in the defined section. I hope you understood. And the third option is use built-in setting width. This is the third option. If you want to start the project from scratch, at that time you have to go with the third option. First is display units. In which unit you want to work? ETAB has given three unit options. US customary. If you want to work in feet and inches, at that time go with this option, US customary. And second is metric SI. If you want to work in kilonewton, meter, second, degree Celsius, at that time go with this option. And third one is metric MKS system. If you want to work in kgs, meter, second, degree Celsius, at that time you can go with this option. I have a PDF files. See, this is the extracted data from the ETAB unit system available in ETAB software, US default. You can find different parameters and their units, which actually the ETAB software is considered. So just go through this file, I will share with you all guys, so that just go through this file and try to understand for different parameters what kind of unit system ETAB will follow. See, metric SI in meter, centimeter, forces in kilonewton, temperature in degree Celsius. Okay, so all these things you can find in this PDF I will share with you. So this is all about the unit system. Then second, steel section database. During your bachelor, you might be heard about the steel sections. Okay, there are different types of steel sections available in market and is vary from country to country. Country has given some standards and industries will according to that standards prepare the sections. Okay, so as per our country, we will select the Indian. Okay. There are many steel section database are available, but as per our choice, we will choose the Indian standard, so that ETAB will record all the standard sections in their memory when we are dealing with the steel structure. At that time we can choose that steel section from the database. Okay, then steel design codes. So for our country, the steel design code is IS 800-2007. Based on other countries, many codes are available, but here we will concentrate on our country code, that is IS 800-2007, for the steel structure. Say IS 800-2007. Then concrete design code. as you all know that our concrete design code is IS 456-2000. Just click on IS 456. Many codes are again available under this category, but we will focus on IS 456-2000. I also have some PDF file that I will share with you different codes available in ETAP software, so you can find the country name and their codes. See, once you go through this file, you can understand something. So without wasting much time on this, I will move forward. Just click on OK. Once you click on OK, new dialog box will open up to form the grids in the ETAP software. See, before modeling of any structure, we need to form the grids. Unless and until you have not formed the grids, you can't model your structure. Grid is just a outlines. Over that outlines we have to work to complete the modeling. So there are three methods of forming the grids in ETAP software. What are those? So there are three methods of forming grids in ETAP software. The first one is offset point method. And the second one is using ETAP templates. And the third option is export and import method. So one by one we will see in which condition which method is more effective. The first option is offset point method. So this is actually not in practice by the practitioners, but is a method so that I will discuss with you offset point methods. The second one is using ETAP templates. Suppose your structure is not much complicated and your structure is orthogonal building, orthogonal plan, at that time practitioners or experts recommend that we should go through the ETAP templates so that there will be less chances of the error in the modeling if you go with this option using ETAP templates. Okay, and the third option is export and import method. We are exporting the AutoCAD plan and importing the ETAP software, so that it is called as export import option or export import method. Suppose there are two types of building. One is orthogonal building and second is non-orthogonal building based on in-plan geometry of the building. Suppose your building is of this type. In-plan geometry of building is like this, whose board dimension is perfectly along X direction and Y direction. So this type of building is called as orthogonal building. Orthogonal building. And your structure is not much big. At that time, experts recommend that go with the second option, that is forming the grid using ETAP's template. We will see later on what does mean by the ETAP's quick templates, how to draw the grid lines using ETAP templates. And the second type, suppose your building is like this. Okay, so whose dimension, board dimension cannot be defined in a particular direction. Okay, so this type of building is called as non-orthogonal building. And your structure is too big and too complicated, at that time the experts recommend that go with the import export option. We are exporting the AutoCAD file and importing the ETAP software so that our work will be less. We can easily start the modeling. We can easily get the base grids in ETAPs. Okay, so this is all about the introduction of different methods of forming the grids in ETAP software. So one by one we will see how to draw the grid lines in ETAPs using these three different options. So just come in ETAP software, don't focus on this. We will see, we will discuss each point in detail later on. First select blank option. Okay, click on blank option, say okay. Two windows will open, window 1 and window 2, and this is the model explorer. After some time I will explain what does mean by model explorer, or how to enable it and how to utilize this model explorer. All things we will discuss later, so I just close it, closing it. Okay, so this is a plan view, this is the 3D view. So what we have to do, we have to draw the grid lines using offset point method. See, we have to draw these grid lines in ETAP software using offset point methods. So we have to take a base point. See, this is the origin point or base point or base joint as an ordinate of 0, 0. Okay, so I will how you can draw this base joint. Just go to draw and choose the option draw joint objects. Okay, this is the, as I earlier told you, this top ribbon is called as this top main menu bar. Okay, that's it. And below which, as you can see here, many options are available. These are the shortcuts. Okay, this is called as quick access bar. How to adjust it, you will see later how to adjust all these things. Okay, so first go to draw joint objects. Okay, see, the unit is asking about asking in inches. As you can see here, we have to insert the dimension in inches, but our drawing is in what? Our drawing is in meter. That means we have to work with the metric SI system. So what we can do, so ETAP has given the option, you can change the unit system anytime. Don't worry, here at the right end corner you can find unit. Once you click it, it will open the options for the units. US default, if you want to work in feet and inches, you can select US default. As I earlier told you, if you want to work in meter, kilonewton, at that time go with the metric SI default option. So as I have to create the grids in metric SI system, so I am choosing this option, metric SI default. Okay, once you select this, now go to draw and draw joint object. Now at this time it is asking in mm, millimeter. So see, we have to position first joint at 0, 0 option. Just go to ETAP, close it, and anywhere you can click, the joint will be drawn. See, as you can find, the joint has been drawn. Okay, so this is the base point. With reference to this base point, we can draw all the joints. Okay, so next point is at a distance of 2 meter from the base point. Just again go to draw joint. 2 meter, in millimeter it becomes 2000. Just close it and click on this option, this base point. See, at a distance of 2 meter, the next point is appear. Now, the third point is at a distance of 4.6 meter from the base point. Just go to draw join, and 4.6 in mm will become 4600. Close it. Click on the base point. See, unless and until red mark is shown, don't click on the join. Once it shows the red mark, then only click on join, so that there will be less possibility of the error in modeling. Remember this point. Okay, this is the red mark. Just click on it so that the next point is drawn at a distance of 4.6 meter from the base point. All the things will be appear in the 3D view also. Whatever the operation you do in the plan view, that will appear simultaneously in the 3D view. Okay, now the fourth point is at a distance of 9.1 meter from the base point. So just go to draw join, and 9.1 will become 9100. Just close it and click on base point, and accordingly the fourth point will be drawn. Now third, next we have to locate the vertical joints or vertical points. So the vertical distance in y direction is 2.8 meter. Okay, at a distance of 2.8 meter. So go to draw joint. See, at this time we have to put the value in y ordinate. See, 2.8 in mm will become 2800. Just close it and click on point. See, at a distance of 2.8 meter, the first point is drawn in vertical direction. Or you can say third direction, second direction, x and y. Then this is at 5.9 meter from the base point. So just go to draw joint in y direction, 5900. Just close it and click on the base point. See, so likewise all the joints has been drawn as per the given data. Now we have to form the grids. Okay, these actually only the joints is completed. We have to form the grids. So how to form the grids? Just go to draw and go to draw with option. Okay, so draw grid lines. Go to draw and find the draw grid lines, draw grids. Once you click it, just close this dialog box, and from the first point, just click on the first point and freely move to the next point and click on the next point. Okay, so first grid is drawn over the height of the building, as you can see in the 3D view. Then select on the upper point and freely move to the next point and click on the next point so that the grid 2 will be drawn. Then select and freely move to the next point, click on it, the third grid will be appear. Similarly in y direction, click on the base point and freely move to the next point and click on it. Again, so like this all the grids has been drawn, as you can see in the 3D view. Okay. So like this, this is the offset point methods, but it is generally not in practice by the practitioners. It's just a method, so it should be in your knowledge. That's why I am sharing with you. Okay. So you can delete all the joints. Just go to select. All these commands we will discuss in detail. I'm just showing you how to do the things. Go to select, select object type and joints. Go to select, all the joints will be selected. You can delete it. Go to edit and delete. Okay. So this, in this way you can form the grids. Okay. You can improve the visibility of the grids. How? Just go to edit, edit story and grid system. Click on this option. Once you click this option, new dialog box will open up. If you have to modify the model or the grids or the height, you can go with this option, modify story data. But we have to make the changes in plan grids. At that time, go with the modify show grid system. So I am selecting on this. So new dialog box will open up. I have to increase the visibility so that I some dark value. Okay, you can change the color of the grids also. You can choose the some dark value also. So click OK. So accordingly you can find here at this window, it shows the updated view of the model or updated view of the grids. As you can see here, the bubbles are overlapping to each other. So we can reduce the size of the bubbles also. So how to reduce the size of bubble? Just choose some lower value, say 1000. Okay, once you click OK, so it will be adjusted automatically. But after reducing the size, it's again overlapping to each other. Okay, I'm choosing some lesser value again, 500. See, at this time all the bubbles are separated clearly. So say OK, then OK. See, okay, the view is changes. Okay, this is some darkened value. So like this you can form the grids by the first option, that is offset point method. Got it? Is that clear to all of you? Hello? Am I audible? Okay, okay. We can proceed. Anybody else? What? Edit option. Okay, okay. Okay, so if you want to change the color of the grids, if you want to change the sizes of the bubbles, whatever you want to do in grids, just go to edit and edit stories and grid system option. Once you click on it, a new dialog box will be open up, and if you want to make the changes over the height, you can go through this option. We will discuss in detail later on this option. But if you want to make changes in plan grids, at that time go to the modify and show grid system. Once you click on it, a dialog box will open up with the different setting options. So there are many things we will discuss one by one in detail in later later topics. But right now I am showing you how to change the colors of the grids. So just click on it. If you want to choose a blue color, just click on it and accordingly the color will be changed. See, the from black it is appeared as a blue color. If you want to change the size of the bubble, you can increase the size. Suppose it is 500, I want to increase the size of bubble, say 1000, and enter. So see, the bubbles are overlapping to each other. If you want to reduce the size of bubble so that it should not overlap to each other, at that time you have to choose some lower value. Type here, suppose 500. Say enter. So all this will be, all the bubbles will be separated. Got it? Okay. So okay. So this, as you can see, the color of the grid has been changed. Is that okay, Nikam? Hello. Got it. Anybody else? Can we continue? Hello. Am I audible? Okay. Okay. So this is all about the first option to draw the grids in ETAP software. Now the second option is using the ETAP template to draw the grids. Go to file, new model. Say no, it's asking to save the model, so I don't need to save the model. So third option, I have to model in structure in metric SI system, that's why I'm choosing a metric SI. Steel section will be Indian. Design code will be IS 800 2007. Concrete code will be IS 456 2000. So I don't need to repeat all this, all the explanation again. Just say okay. Once you click on okay, a quick templates will open up. By using this template, you can draw the grids of the ETABs, grids in ETABs. So this grid system we have to draw right now. See, this is the grid. There are 5 grids in x direction, 6 grids in x direction, A, B, C, D, E, F, and from bottom to top 1, 2, 3 up to 6. So ETABs are followed the numbering of the grids from left to right in an alphabetical order, say A, B, C, D, E, F, and from bottom to top it's followed the, followed as numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Keep in mind, from left to right is given the naming to the grids as A, B, C, D in alphabetical order, and from top to bottom as numbering. Got it? So we have to, as you can see, the spacing between all grids is similar, that is 3 meter 3 meter 3 meter 3 meter 3 meter, so that it is a uniform spacing in x direction. As you can find in y direction, spacings are again same 5 5 5. So in y direction again it is of uniform spacing. So overall this grid system is uniform grid system, okay, with the uniform spacing. So we have to draw this grid. Go to ETAP. Number of grid line, uniform grid spacing, non-uniform grid spacing, that means custom grid spacing. We will discuss about custom grid spacing later. First we have to focus on uniform grid spacing. So as you can find the number of grids in x direction, so 1 2, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In x direction, there are 6 grids. Just go to, in x direction, there is 6 grid. Okay, insert the value as 6. Number of grids in y direction. So how many grids in y direction? See, 6 grids are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So I just put the value as 6. In x direction it is 6, in y direction it is 6. In the both direction the number of grids are 6. Spacing of grids in x direction, so as there is a uniform spacing, you can put the single value, that is 3 meter. So put as 3 meter in x direction and 5 meter in y direction. Got it? Specify grid labeling option. As I earlier told you, it has followed labeling of the grids from left to right as alphabetical order, say A. And from bottom to top, it is labeling the grids as numbering 1, 2, 3 and going likewise, it gives the number to the grids. Okay. ETAB has given the option, you can change from the default setting, you can give the naming from right to left, or you can give the naming from top to bottom. But I am not making any change in the default setting, just say okay. Got it? Okay. And this is the story dimension. This is all about the implant setting, this is all about the setting over the height of the structure. So over the height of structure, we will discuss in detail later, but right now I am giving the values that are given here. The total number of stories is 5. So write here as 5. Total number of stories is 5. Typical story height. What does mean by the typical story height? We will see this. We will discuss in detail later. So right now the typical story height is 3 meter. So put the value as 3 meter. Now next, bottom story height. What does mean by the bottom story height? How to find the bottom story height? How to decide the bottom story height? That we will see. We will discuss in detail in later session or in later topics. Right now we will put the value as 2.5 meter. Put the value as 2.5 meter. Okay. But at this time, we don't need to go with the blank option. If you are selecting blank option, there will be no appearance of any grid. But right now, we actually want the grids, so that I am selecting the option grids only. Just click on it and say OK. See, the grids by default will be appear like this. So it is very faint and you want to improve the visibility. Again, go to edit stories and grid system, modify and show grid system, and you can choose some dark value, say okay. Again, the bubbles are overlapping to each other in x direction, so choose some lesser value, say 800. So it's again overlapping 700. Okay, now it's okay. So okay. See, the visibility is somewhat increased. Okay, so like this you can draw the grids using ETAB's templates. This is all about the uniform grid spacing grids. Okay. Now the second option, or the second non-uniform grids. At this time, we have to draw this grid system in ETAB software. How we can draw now? Come back to the ETABs. Now at this time, we have to form non-uniform grid spacing system. So come back to the ETAB software, go to file, new model. It is again asking to save the model, say no. Okay, go through the third option. Once you selected all the settings, ETAB by default will set that settings. We don't need to make changes again and again. So okay. Now come back to new model quick templates. See, at this time we have to draw this grid system. Okay, so as you can find here, the spacing between two grid is not uniform. See, distance between A to B is 4.5 meter. Distance between B to C is 6.6 meter. Likewise, distance between every two grids is different. Similarly, in Y direction, as you can find, distance between two grids is different. Got it? So what actually we need to do? We have to draw, we need to go with the custom grid spacing option. But before that, we can use, we can make our work somewhat easy by using uniform grid spacing option. How many grids in x direction? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 grids in x direction. See, if I am going with this being uniform grid spacing setting as 4, 4, 8, 8 and just go to custom, see, here will be appearance of only 4 grids A, B, C, D. Okay, so I can use this feature. If I am choosing the value as 7 grids and go to custom, at this time there will be 7 grids. Okay, so it makes our work more easy. So you can use this feature, uniform grid spacing. So I will put the value as, suppose we have to there is a 100 grids in x direction. So what you will do, just if you go with this grid option, you need to go with the add again, you again and again you need to add the grids. So at that time what you should do, just put the value as 100. Once you put the value 100, so in x direction, it in custom grid spacing option, it will automatically give you 100 grids in x direction. See, okay. So that's why I'm telling you all guys, put the value, put the number as 7 in x direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, in y direction, how many grids are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put the value 5. No doubt, we anyhow we have to use this custom grid of spacing option. But we can use this option to make the work more easy, more effective, and with less time consumption. Okay, so put the value as 5. Spacing of grids in x direction. So can you find the similar value in x direction with the same spacing that is coming again and again? So as you can find, 5 is repeated dimension, 5 and 5, so I can put it as 5. In y direction, you can find 3.5 is repeating value. You can put the value as 3.5. so that what happen when you go with the custom grid spacing, so according to uniform spacing, it will updated the values. So you don't need to work much at this point. The incremental value is 5. See, 5, 10, 15, 20. And in y direction, the uniform spacing we have chosen as 3.5. So 0, 3.5, 7, 10.5, 14. Got it? Okay, that's fine. Now, rectangular grids, as you can find here, two options. Display grid data as ordinate, display grid data as spacing. There are two options to put the values for the ordinates. Okay, so first option means display grid data as ordinate. In this case, you have to set the baseline. Suppose grid A is your baseline and you have to put the distance between A to B as 4.5 meter. And for the grid C, you have to put the value from baseline A grid. So again and again you need to add the values. 4.5 plus 6.6, that will become 11.1. then 4.5 6.6 5, that will become 16.1. so under this option, you have to put the value by adding the grid spacing. So by using this option, what you have to do, first a grid will be as origin. Now second is at a distance of 4.5 meter, so put the value as 4.5. next, C grid is at a distance of 4.5 plus 6.1, you need to add the values and put the value as 11.1. say 11.1 from the base grid A. Now D as a distance of 4.5 plus 6.6 plus 5, that will become 16.1. put the value as 16.1. so as you can find, it's a very tedious job, it's a very time consuming job to put the values by adding all the grid distances. So ITAM has given second option, display grid data as spacing. So once you click on it, so accordingly all the data will be changed. At this time you have to put the distance between two grids only. So you have to put the distance between A to B in reference of A, that is 4.5. what distance between A to B in reference of A will be equal to 4.5. distance between B to C in reference of B will be 6.6. got it? Distance between C to D in reference of C will be 5, and the distance between D to E in reference of D will be 3.5. then the distance between E to F in reference of E will be 6.5, and the distance between F to G in reference of F will be 5, and in the last, the difference distance between G to the next grid, as you can find there is no any grid, that's why we need to put the value as 0 for the G grid. Got it? So here will by default the value will be 0. I hope you all understood. Now in Y direction, spacing between grid 1 and 2 is 3.5, so put the value as 3.5 in reference of 1. 2 to 3, it will be 4 in reference of 2, so 4. 3 to 4 in reference of 3, that will be 3.5. and distance between grid 4 to 5 in reference of 4 will be 5, put the value as 5. This 3.5, this 4, this 3.5 again, then this 5. This 5. Okay. So see, like this, you have completed the in-plan grids. You can choose some dark value. So okay, you can adjust the bubble size. I'm choosing the value as 1000, say okay. So in plan settings has been completed. Now we have to set the data over its height. So total number of stories, how many number of stories is there? 10. Put the value as number of stories as 10. Typical story height, that is 3.3 meter. Put the value as 3.3 meter. Okay, what does mean by typical story height? Suppose if you are dealing with the high rise structure, suppose you are dealing with the high rise structure and there are many floors, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. So there are many floors, and the floor to floor height is 3 meter, 3 meter, 3 meter, and in between the floor height is suppose 2.9 meter, then again 3 meter, then 3 meter. So the repeating value is what? 3. So we can say the typical story height is 3 meter. Got it? That's why we are calling it as typical story height, the repeating value, typical story height. And bottom story height means what? The distance between top of the footing, suppose, see, what does mean by bottom story height? We will see in detail in later session. So this is the foundation and this is the plinth level, okay, and this is the ground level. In ETABS, we are not modeling the structure with these different levels. We are merging these levels as plinth level. In ETABS, we are not drawing the ground level. What we will do, we have merged this level and drawing the single level as plinth level. So from the top of the footing to the plinth level, from the top of the footing to the plinth level, that is called as bottom story height. Remember, what does mean by bottom story height? The distance between top of the footing to the plinth level, that is called as bottom story height. Got it? So the bottom story height, as we have given as 2.5 meter. See, the bottom story has 2.5 meter. ETABS by default will generate the base of the structure as 0, 0. Okay. You can go with the custom story data option, go to edit. Okay, so this story data will be open in new dialog box. So, okay, in this situation, as I told you, it has by default will create a level as base at the base of the structure, or it is considered as a foundation level base at 0, 0. The first story we can make it as plinth level. You can edit whatever the naming you want, you can insert here. This is the story first, say S1, say S2, this will be the S3, this will be the S4, this will be the S5, this will be the S6. Likewise, you can change the name of the story. S9. The height of that particular floor is given here. 2.5 from the base, then height of individual floor 3.3 is a typical story height. This is the elevation, cumulative height from the base. The plinth is at a height of 2.5 meter from the base. The first story level is at a distance of 5.8 meter from the base. The total height of the structure will become 32.2 meter. What does mean by master story? What does mean by similar story? That all things we will discuss in later session. Got it? So okay. So grids only. Again choose the option grids only. Say okay. So in this way, the grids will be formed in plan as well as over the height of the structure. So this is the way to form the grids using ETABS templates. Got it? If you want to change the size, color, and if you want to change, make the changes in grids, you can go with the edit option, edit story, stories and grid system, modify the grids, modify and show grid option. You can make the changes as per your requirement. Even you can make the change in the spacing also. You can make the changes in vertical direction also. Vertical direction means in y direction. Okay, in y direction you can change the color of the grids also. You can change the sizes of the bubbles. All the things I have explained in very detail. Okay, so say okay. Okay, so this is all about the uniform grid spacing or non-uniform grid spacing. So in later session, the time is over. So in next session, we will discuss about how to draw the grids in cut in cylindrical format. And in next session, we have to discuss about how to draw the grids in cylindrical format. Okay, and in later session we have to discuss how to export the AutoCAD plan, AutoCAD center line from the AutoCAD, and how to import that plan in ETAP so that our work will be more easy for modeling the structure. Got it? So it's all about today's session, and if you have any query, any doubt, you may ask questions.